Let us see ninth question, children. In the adjoining figure, first observe the figure, children. This is the figure they have given. Children, if you observe here, line AB is there, line CD is there. Here AB and CD are intersecting at O. Okay, and OE is the ray. The starting point of OE is O here. So the line AB, the line CD, and the ray OE are intersecting at O. So how many angles we are getting here? Angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4, and angle 5. First observe the figure carefully, and then we are going to answer the questions what they asked. So AB and CD are intersecting at O, and OE ray is also intersecting at O, and we are having 5 angles formed here. So let us see the first question here. Is angle 1 is adjacent to angle 2. First of all, what are adjacent angles? If two angles, we are calling it as adjacent angles, they should have a common vertex, common arm, and the non-common arms are separated by the common arm. Is angle 1 is adjacent to angle 2. Where is angle 1? Observe the figure, children. Here it is angle 1. Here it is angle 2. Children, so angle 1 is AOC and angle 2 is COE. So they have the common vertex O, common arm OC, and the non-common arms OA and OE are separated by the common arm OC. So clearly we can say that angle 1 and angle 2 are adjacent. So we have to write yes here. Clear? Coming to second bit. Is angle AOC adjacent to AOE? Again, coming back to the figure, children. Where is AOC here? AOC and AOE. AOE. AOC and AOE. Of course, they have the common vertex O, but they don't have the common arm here. So, what we have to write? They are not adjacent. Clear to everyone? Now, coming to third one. Do angle COE and EOD form linear pair? Children, what is the definition of a linear pair? The first of all, there should be adjacent angles, and the non-common arms should be opposite to each other. Where is COE here? COE and EOD. EOD. COE is angle 2 and EOD is angle 3 plus angle 4. So COE and EOD have the common vertex O, common arm OE, and OC and OD are opposite rays. So clearly we can say that they are linear pair. Next, coming to fourth one, children. Angle BOD and DOA are supplementary. You already know what are supplementary angles. So some of the angles should be equal to 180 degrees or half circle. Where is BOD, children? BOD and DOA. Clearly they are forming a half circle which is equal to 180 degrees. So angle BOD and DOA are supplementary. Coming to fifth one, is angle 1 vertically opposite to angle 4? What are vertically opposite angles, children? If two lines intersect, the opposite angles we are calling it as vertically opposite angles. Where is angle 1 here? Here, angle 1 is forming here and angle 4 is here. So, the line AB and CD are intersecting at O, and the opposite angles are angle 1 and angle 4. So clearly they are vertically opposite angles. aspect. What is the vertically opposite angle to angle 5? Where is angle 5, children? This completely AOD is angle 5 here. So this line and this line are intersecting. This is opposite to which angle, ma? This completely. Yes or not, children? So we can write it as COB or angle 2 plus angle 3. So what is the vertically opposite angle to angle 5? Is vertically opposite to angle COB, COB or angle 2 plus angle 3. Is this clear to everyone? Children, let us see 10th question. Indicate which pair of angles are vertically opposite angle, linear pair. Observe the figure here, children. What are vertically opposite angles here? If you observe the figure here, if two lines intersect, the opposite angles we are calling it as vertically opposite angles. So after observing here, angle 1 is opposite to angle 4. So one pair is angle 1 comma angle 4. Let us see any other pairs are there. Here angle 5 is opposite to angle 2 plus angle 3. So angle 5 is equal to angle 2 plus angle 3. So angle 5 is vertically opposite to angle 2 plus angle 3. Coming to linear pair. Linear pair, let us see here, children. Angle 1 and angle 5 are linear pair. So one pair is angle 1 and angle 5. Next pair, angle 5 and angle 4. A linear pair. Let us see 11th question, children. In the following figure, is angle 1 adjacent to angle 2? And they are asking reason for that one. Here, if you observe the figure, here angle 1 is here and angle 2 is here. Clearly we can say that angle 1 and angle 2 are not adjacent because they don't have the common vertex. So what is the reason you have to write? Angle 1 and angle 2 are not adjacent since they don't have common vertex. Yes. Coming to 12th question, children. Find the values of the angles, the unknown values x, y and z. If you observe the figure here, children, here two lines are intersecting. So four angles are forming here. Here they have given angle x, angle y, angle z, and here the angle is 55 degrees. Children, if two lines intersect, they can form four angles in which vertically opposite angles are equal, right? So these two lines are intersecting here and angle x is vertically opposite to angle 55 degrees here. So since vertically opposite angles are equal, I can say that angle x is equal to 55 degrees, and you can give the reason here, since they are vertically opposite, angles are equal. Let us find out the unknown y and z here. If you observe the figure, children, angle x and angle y are linear pair. So sum of the two angles is equal to 180 degrees here. So angle x plus angle y is equal to 180 degrees. Already you got it, angle x is equal to 55 degrees. So 55 degrees plus angle y is equal to 180 degrees, which implies angle y is equal to 180 degrees minus 55 degrees, which is equal to 125 degrees. So what is the reason we are using here? They are linear pair. And again, since angle y and angle z are vertically opposite angles and vertically opposite angles are equal here, so angle y is equal to angle z, which is equal to 125 degrees. Therefore, angle x is equal to 55 degrees, angle y is equal to 125 degrees, comma, angle z is equal to 125 degrees. Is this clear, children?